Every scumbag in the Commonwealth's gonna know our names.
Shut. What are you doing with that screwdriver? Hey, everybody, and welcome back to episode 226, Fallout 4. Last episode, did a little bit of base building and, you know, discovered some of the new items that we've been given with the crafting interface, and it is quite nice. I'm a fan. Now, I want to put these lights right here. Ooh, and they're powered already. Nice. That's gonna look really cool at night. We can see the door, yes, but at night we can see the door all the better. And this is also our Honey Waffle House, and there's nothing you can do to tell me to change that, because Honey Waffles, fuck yeah. Put a recruitment bacon in here, so we're getting settlers, and I'm gonna leave that there for now. Actually, let me rotate to make it a little bit easier to get up there. But I put my power conduits up top, so my lights should have no problem working here. I would actually like it to be night so I can figure out some spacing. These don't have power, and that's fair enough because I haven't put any conduits over here. Now the spacing, it's on that one, and okay, so there's one thing of gap, like there's one board, one beam of distance between these. And then you go here. I'll have to figure out what I'm doing like this. And I could put lights on the walls if I wanted to. Why don't I do this and skip one? And sure. Then we'll do the same thing here. Just get this place lit the fuck up. Because I hate a dark building. I hate not being able to see what I'm inside here. If it's my own settlement, I think I should be able to see. Alright, let's put a few more conduits up top. We're really killing the settlement size, by the way. It's come a long way since we first started. Alright, let's place a few down. And wire them up. And we'll have to look through the floor here to see if we're... What's my maximum distance? Right there. We'll have to look through the floor to see if we're actually powering the other lights. So what I'll do is just scoot you right there. So again, I put a couple down at a time so I can wire them up, then I can maximize the distance, because the wire has a limit, as you can see right there, that it can be placed, the distance that is. So as far as I can go is right there. Alright, how far can I go with you? Not very. Right, nope, that was there. Alright, let's see. Probably easier to take a corner piece off, and I can obviously just press tab. So, that one does not have power. That doesn't have power. So we'll have to go probably one conduit this way and one conduit that way. So if I just press tab, you can see it goes back. Nice. Probably going to move the beds. I don't think they're going to stay there permanently. That kind of looks stupid. We'll see. Nothing's final yet. Nothing's final yet. I mean, these are all subject to change at a later date anyway. I'm just kind of putting things down here to get things started. So let's scooch you over. Now, no. I would wager that everything's good down here. Yes. Okay, so just one more over there and we ought to be fine. And I can't wait to see what this place looks like. I'm tempted to sleep. What are my statuses? Because I know I'm hungry and thirsty and such. Require frequent sleep, so we have fatigue, which we'll fix that here soon. Mildly dehydrated, so we're minus 4 int already, so our idiot savant chances are already pretty high, which is fantastic. I'm aiming to have low int while building, so I can get extra XP while doing this. Is more idiot savant procs is fine by me. Is that too far? Ooh, it's close. Could not have squeezed much more distance out of that. No, sir. So now everything should be connected. The conduits look all silly up here. I didn't get a light on there. That's fair enough. Some of these will probably need moved later on, but for now that's close enough. I would sleep to pass time, but I don't want to benefit my statistics in any way. I see the fedora, and I'm like, is that Nick running at me? I'm so used to seeing Nick in his damn fedora. I don't know if I want to put lights on the outskirts. Don't know. Alright, now defense. Since we have conduits up there, we could get fancy and we could slap down some actual power and roll with the rocket turrets. We could do that. Now, the machine gun turrets have always done work. Advanced switches. Terminal transmits power of all outputs up. Man, you can get fancy. I'm so glad they added that shit. A marquee, for real. Dude, that's amazing. I can add a marquee to my door. They added so much shit, you gotta love it. Alright, I'm thinking maybe a few rocket turrets. Let me actually look at them like, resource-wise real quick. Missile turrets, 28 versus I can do 42 heavy machine guns. What's the difference in resources? Aluminum circuitry screw gear oil. Okay, this one doesn't require aluminum. What's the limiting factor? Probably oil? Yeah, oil. Well, we don't need too many of these. They require 2 power each, so we'll have to be careful. Now, I don't know where the attacks are going to originate from. Until I know for sure, that sucks. And I can't see which way this thing actually looks, what its radius is. I don't remember. So, I'll do something like this. And we'll fill in the gaps with probably heavy missile turrets. Or not heavy missile, heavy machine gun turrets. Yeah, we'll put one there. Gas canister removed. Ah, see, it's scrapping down resources that I had already. And fuck it, we'll give one an overlook that way. Alright, so they each require 2 power, so it's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Okay, we need quite a few generators to take care of that. And if I do it this way, because those things don't require actual power, the lights down there. So if we need, let's rotate it the same way. We need 12 power. That's already 6. 9. 69. And 12. So, if I line these all up. Yay, dehydrated. More int. Maybe. Maybe. I think it caps at 4. No, caps at 8. Or it's at 8 now. Nice. Even more. We are practically disabled, okay? Well, like, all of our int is gone, and it's great. This is what I want. So that's not going to reach. No way, no fucking hell. I'll have to slap a conduit down. Same thing here, I'll have to put conduits. So, let's do just that. Nick, I'm surprised you managed a pathfind up here. Maybe? Negatory. Alright, we'll just use this one. Right there. And this one will connect. Remember, these are all on the same grid, which is nice. Yes! I was worried about that one for a second. And... you... Okay, you're the only one left. So one more conduit for you because you're special. And just pull as far back as possible. Close enough. You here. Alright, so every single one of them appears to be operational. Now let's look at like the protection radius they have. Okay, there's some overlapping here. How far do you look to the left? Quite a bit. There's nothing here. I'll probably put machine gun turrets down. Alright, so because machine gun turrets don't require power, let's give a few of them... Did they change the aesthetic? Or no, it just looks weird on the... It's like gray on the like the icon down below. It's like actually, it's more like black, like a dark gray. Even though the turret's like completely shiny. I don't know, it looks weird. Let's fill in the gaps. This place is going to have some ridiculous defense because of those turrets. Those rocket turrets give a donkulous defensive value. I can't put any turrets there, which is annoying because that's going to create like a blind spot. I'll put you there, which does create a blind spot here if someone wants to camp it. The generators aren't exactly protected, so I may pull them back and then put like a wall around them so something doesn't break the generators and then turn off all of my turrets minus the machine gun turrets. That's probably a really good idea, actually. So... that might cause an issue. Actually, maybe it won't with... because what I'd be worried about is the clipping of the wires with the walls. I think I'll be okay. Because there's a spot here I think I can work with pretty well. You're going to snap. Interesting that you don't snap up here. Because, you know, there's obviously these... like these floorboards that... I don't know. They'll snap the wall, I bet. Yeah. You're going to snap the way I'm... hoping you will. Of all things to not snap to. Why will you not snap in this direction? The one angle that I want you to snap. it probably want to go this way. All right. So it doesn't have to be perfect. Tell you what. Can I store that one? Is it like a silly prefab that'd fit the bill? That would fit the bill. The whole... oh, wait, no, this has an opening. There's one with a close. Yes. All I want to do is put the generators in there. So, like, You'd really have to try to be able to break these. Alright, so moving these is going to be annoying because they're all linked up. I could break them, but eh. I'll probably have to put another conduit down. Yep, I foresaw that one. So, let's do one more conduit. The only thing annoying about placing all these conduits is... The power conduits, they contribute to settlement size. It's going to turn everything off. Yep. Alright, link. Link. Okay, everything should be active. Nice. Alright, so that should give me more play. Gotta make sure there's a line of sight. Let's bring these closer. I actually got a really... I think it's because... I think the reason I'm able to get so far away with the generator is because the point that the wire is, like, up in the air, it's higher than the conduits on the ground. Oh, spacebar, you would do that. And if I think of the ground, if the wire touches the ground, it won't let you place it. That's probably what the power lines would be better for. There's really tall power lines you see in the crafting menu. I haven't really been using them. I haven't really needed to. Alright, I realize this is incredibly messy looking, but it'll come together nicely soon, I promise. Assuming I can squeeze all the generators in here. I think I can. I hope I can. I should. I should be able to. You need to come closer. You're next up. Awesome. Okay. That wire is actually going to need to be severed. And then we'll just link it to this one. There you go. That's it. I could obviously just put like a single generator in here, like a really powerful one or something. But these are like super cheap. Super cheap. Gotta save them resources, because we'll be building a million other settlements. And there you go. I could even put a light in here, make it look fancy. So, line that, or link that one up. And they're all linked up anyway. I guess I could just do that for shits and giggles. There you go. And if I slap a light down in there for the walls, which I will. There you go. And like at night, you know, that'll light up and look really cool. Awesome. So why don't I do something like this? Just kind of, I'll line it up a little bit. Sure, why not? All right, now there's no rocket turret over here. Huh. I think it'd be fine without it. In fact, I will just put a second heavy machine gun turret. So you overlook that. You there. Look, I think it's well enough defended. So again, I don't know where the attack is going to originate from. Let's pop a save down. How much building space do we use? Quite a bit. Alright, so like, unless somebody spawns over there and shoots inwards, or like this person over here somehow banks a grenade, this is pretty safe. It's pretty well off. And I'm going to get rid of the staircase so nothing can like walk up here. And as long as they're in the building or around the building, like if I put my farms here, then they're going to be working in front of, so they're going to have the coverage of all these turrets. So pretty much I want to like somehow line everything up. Or again, I could just put it here and this is a kill zone. I mean, shit, you just put all the crops here. Everybody's working in the field and all these turrets are overlooking them. Either I'm making sure they do their job, and if they don't, I blow them up, or I have them very well defended. It just depends how you look at it. let's see. So now we need to get food down though. And what are we lowest on? Mute fruit and potatoes, I think, have been my usual lowest, but that's also because I haven't been harvesting every single place. So maybe later on I'll move some of these crops into the building. I don't know. We're running into a problem with settlement size. So we'll see. But for now, get some potatoes down. And I have not counted all of these. It's a half a value, so that's one, it's two, three, 4, 5, 6. That's one settler's worth. Because they can do 6 food value each. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I just guess I had them more tightly knit, or did I count incorrectly? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I counted incorrectly. Shocker. So, can I... There, and... Come on. There. Close enough. Now I could space them out to make them look a little more pretty if I wanted to. Is it just too close, or what's the dealio there? Why does that one not want to place? Okay, it was too close. I think. Why does that one not want to place? It's like so uncooperative. Maybe I'll just increase the space between them. Line them up a little bit, make it look a little fancy. So now we have two settlers worth of food value here. And I'm definitely going to get on with a mute fruit. Because mute fruit's something I need. I interrupted them. Poor guys. Keep going. There you go. That looks nice. That's fancy. Okay, and that's probably like the pattern I'm going to roll with for now. I like it. Works for me. Mute fruit. And now remember, these are one food value. So that's one settler. That's 3, 4, 5, 6. It's an entire settler's food value. 2. Oh, I'm not going to be able to squeeze it in. 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we need an entire extra plant down. It's not perfect, but that's okay. So that is an extra 12 food value right there. So we're going to have quite the ridiculous amount of food. Why is one of these not... Why did the food value not update to 12? Did I miscount? Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Got that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me just reassign them. Nope. I meant to look at this person to assign the task. There it is. It's 12. I just had to reset them. So as we get more settlers, they will assign themselves to food. We'll have more than enough food. And I could do corn if I wanted to, or could slap down more mute fruit. I know I have tons of corn in other places. I think I have enough mute fruit. Let's do just one line of corn, and then we'll call it there. That'll be enough for this settlement. I don't know how often I'm ever going to actually come to this place, though. So I don't want to get the food value too high, so we have to worry about too much defense, but I think if you look at the defense value up there, we're fine. So that's 2 food. 3. Corn's a little bit weird with placement. 4, 5. Oh, it's gonna let me get away with placing it on there. It looks stupid as shit, but that should be. That's at 2, 3, 4, 5, and I'm actually really surprised I'm not able to squeeze the plants in there a little closer. That's weird. All right, well, we'll just go past it a bit. Nice. There you go. So we have some floating corn. This place is very unique. But as we get settlers, they will assign themselves to that, and we will be good to go. I don't need a vendor here just yet. I do have some junk, but nothing really warranting it. Plus, I'm a bit short on caps after what we did, you know, with like the 4 extra shops that I put down that I thought I could relocate, but I couldn't. Look at this place. It's so vibrant. So very vibrant. I have this entire open area to work with. Probably going to put my crafting stations in here. I just wish you could move your fucking workshop. Oh, that bugs me. You can't move that once it's there. It's static. That's where it stays. Let me just store that pump and probably put it somewhere else. Oh, everything's growing. Nice. Because I definitely want a pump that I can drink out of. In fact, why not just put it at the entrance to this place? Because, you know, I do that so I don't have to... I can save bottles of water, whatnot. Might move the beds back a bit, but let's see here. Crafting... Obviously, you can access the workshop from within these interfaces, so it doesn't really matter. Let me put this in the corner. Man, look at the lighting in here. It's so fucking vibrant. Feels good, man. It's got a chem station, armor. That's right, we only get that one armor station, right? Yeah, one armor workbench. Okay, armor workbench. Voila. Cooking station. I like the stove because it's nice and compact. And it looks the fanciest, I'd say. A power armor station. We'll just go put you in the corner. I don't think I have a power armor suit here right now. And this weapons workbench. There you go, maybe? Nice. Alright, so this place has all the crafting interfaces that I want. Stores, again, we'll probably put some later. Decorations. Wall decorations. What do we want to slap down? Some paintings? Any cool paintings in here? Any new extra ones that we got? Fancy? Oh, there's a storm coming in, and it sounds like it's a rad storm. That's a red storm. Okay. Not worried about that. Alright, just use that one. Let's come up with a different painting. Sure. Look at that settlement happiness go up. They should. Here, they get to have a cute doge. And a kitty playing with a toy rocket. What's not the love? And a lighthouse? It's a bit dark. Oh, this is actually really nice, because this makes it super, super, super dark. I think even darker than night. Yeah, the fire rads, I'm not worried about. We'll put a decontamination arch here somewhere. This makes it easier to see where I need to put light. Alright, that one. Okay, I'll take care of that. Actually, let me turn my Pip-Boy off, my Pip-Boy light. Okay, just making sure it was off. Bring up the interface, thank you. There. I almost can't even tell if it's on or not. I think the light that you lose from the Radstorm is like a little tad dramatic. I don't know. Oh my god, can I posit- I can corner it? Dude, that's so cool that it actually let me corner it between the- Dude, nice! I thought it would only go on a flat surface. I like that. If only I could get rid of the stupid bushes there. It looks so goofy. My rads are probably pretty- Yeah, they're getting up there. Oh man, look at it. It's so spooky out here. I'm getting all these rads. Whatever will I do? Decontamination arch hype! Alright, ooh, hello. Junk mortar. No way! We can actually make these now? There's one settlement I know has them. I wonder if we can actually use them. Like, fires objects. I wonder if we can actually aim with that or how that's gonna work. Launches firework shells when power. Shells can be crafted at a chem station. Dude, that's... Plays a musical tone when powered. You can change the pitch. Nice. Oversized Nixie tube. I have no idea what that's supposed to be. Cycling light. Connected terminal access additional functionality. Nice. Clears radiation damage when powered. Alright. Probably just put you like right there. And can I? Nice. Very nice. Yoink. Obviously I'm getting rads and shit right now, but you see. That's cool. Oh, that's so cool. Alright, so let me just do another once over the settlement. Plenty of defense. Probably slap down some more beds, enough power, not worry about that. Once we start getting more people, we'll start getting more food. Let me harvest all this stuff. Well. It's every potato and shit I just put down, I just got back, which is fantastic.
You've no idea the relief I feel right now. Those raiders won't be back anytime soon.
Unless they can resurrect. No, they're fucked. They're done.
I need to assign someone to this.
Obviously, no one's assigned that. So I guess it's not growing. I did notice last episode. I didn't say anything. Obviously, but there's Mylarks out there. I don't think I'll be able to detect them with bats from here. Nah, I could plink them and probably kill them, but at risk of their corpses not just. I don't want to let the corpses disappear. Obviously, I'd prefer to get the loot, whatever loot they may have on them. So I'll leave them alone. But this place has come a long
now that you've dealt with
way.
Raiders.
And he just keeps talking about them raiders. Hey, and the Radstorm's gone. That was quick. So, let's see here. I'm going to put away the extra potatoes that I got. Quite a few. Some vodka. And I should double check to make sure this place is a supply line. Store my junk. I want to hang on to my ammo for the moment. Alright, so map. Supply lines. Yes, this is supply line, so we have quite the expansive supply line coverage at this point. Nice, 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 nice. Let's turn them off. Come on, no, zoom out, thank you. Okay, so we've been down the Fort Strong, that's been cleared. Easy City's down, cleared. So we're gonna go to East Boston Prep here and clear that out. See what's what. Cause I think this place is done for the moment. The food value, again, the food value is gonna go up. The defensive value is low. Oh, this, okay. It requires actual. I forgot. This isn't a freebie like the light. So that's why the defensive value went low, because we don't have enough juice. So one, yeah, that turret right there is deactive. So I can probably squeeze another generator in there. If I can't, maybe I'll change some things up. Can I push you back any further? Maybe just a touch. Every bit counts right now. I doubt I'm going to be able to put another generator right there. Oh, no, maybe not. Maybe I will. Let me see if I can squeeze another generator in there. Generator, regular one. Ooh. Negatory. I can kind of squeeze one there. Might have to. Well, I wonder. Like, if I go to the generators, how big is this one? The problem is this only does 5. That's why I never really use those. Like, this is a huge generator. I can't even build it because I need the science. Like, that's a fucking gigantic generator. But look what it says for power. 3. Like, these are so teeny. They do 3. They're so very efficient. Space efficiency. Yeah, I'm probably gonna have to just nut up and allow that one to exist in that fashion. That's fine. It's not hurting anything. It doesn't look as cool as I would have wanted, but I'm not gonna cry over it. So 154 defensive value. Food value will go up as settlers figure out what the hell they're doing, and of course I'll assign people to shops and such in the long run. I could even sure, let's add some extra power to the grid. Because that one's 2. There. Nice. But yeah, we'll food value go, we'll be fine. I probably ought to slap some more beds down, though. I haven't completely, flushed out this building, but I kind of want to get back to exploring. But if I put more beds down, then as the recruitment begging gets people will not have to complain about beds. Because it's 10 plus, your charisma or something is the max settlement count. Or settler count. So it could still go up. In fact, it probably will. So, you know what? Why don't I just fucking go to 20? I don't think I'm ever really going to have that much charisma, but there we go. Good enough for me. So let's pop a quick save, and I think it's already time to wrap the episode up. Sorry to say, let me use the decontamination arch. Because I have a little bit of extra radiation there from the end of the red storm. But let's go ahead and wrap it up. Let me just get another quick save just so I can feel good about myself. Nordhagen Beach, as far as I'm concerned, is pretty much on lock for now. If we need to, we'll tweak it later. But I'm going to head over to East Boston Prep School and see what's what and clear out Boston Airport and get back to the main quest for a little bit. Not all of it, but I want to do enough that we can progress Nick and some other people. Awesome. Good shit. So getting out up here, guys. Episode 226. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.